Hey, I'm Look Mum No Computer. So you're probably watching this video because you think these little vacuum tubes from old-timey electronics are pretty damn cool. And what you want to do is pop one into a synth, but you don't want to deal with all those scary high voltages. You might have seen those amazing bright yellow Metasonics panels or the absolutely insane Knifonioum, which is like an all-valve synthesizer. Even the noise is a valve that is being affected by magnetic fields or something like that. And you're saying, Sam, these were out of date in the 1960s. Why are they still being used? That's because they're attributed with quite a warm, distinct, fuzzy sound that sometimes can sound pretty fucked. Take valve guitar amps, for instance. They just have a little bit more about them. So in the DIY guitar pedal world, there's actually a well-known low voltage valve overdrive design by a guy called Matsumin called the Valvecaster. And it's kind of like a saturating power boost using a 12AX7 dual triode valve, also known as an ECC83. And the amazing thing is, because it's low voltage, it's underpowered, which makes it sort of frazzlier. And the cool thing is, the valve still glows because the actual glowing is from the heating filaments in the valves. And these, even in a high voltage application, are still only powered by 6 volts. So that's all well and good for guitar pedals, but what about the bad news? The bad news is the Valvecaster is designed for guitar line levels, which is a heck of a lot lower than the level of a synth. And even if you wanted to bring this up to the level of a synth, you wouldn't be able to because you just won't have enough oomph in there. So we need to tweak the circuit a little bit, add a couple more components to bring it up to synth level. So here's a Valvecaster circuit ready for synthesizers. It's called the safety valve because, you know, even if you lick it, which I would not recommend, it's not gonna zap you to Zanzibar. So yeah, let's get this singing. So to start with, we get the aluminium board. This one is 10 centimeters by 20 centimeters and it's 2 millimeters thick. I am sharpieing all of the dots of where I'm gonna drill it. Very precise, very precise. And then we're gonna get some pilot holes, really thin, maybe a 2 millimeter. And then you get big drill bits specifically for whatever size your things are, your components. This 22 centimeter one is for the valve socket, which there is a link in the website. And then you put it on the thing, drill some pilot holes for the screws that you mount it with, knock it out, take it all off, give it a good old sand so it gets all nice and rough so it can take the paint. Lovely. And then spray it. That is actually water-based spray paint. I found it works better. Give it a heat, cook it down. Then you get your silver Sharpie out, do some little doodles. You can do whatever you want. You're the artist here. And then a bit of clear coat lacquer. Lovely. And then after that, pop it back, cook it, you know, cure it. And then you start putting all of the components into the actual panel. Those are the potentiometers. I haven't actually got the tool to tighten them up, so I use a plier. And then put the knobs on because it's got to look nice straight away. You know? Now it's time for the strip board. The bigger the better, because if you make mistakes, you want bigger bits. Get a drill bit to break the copper strips underneath the IC socket. Lovely, look at that. And now you do some soldering on the IC socket, looking nice. Start with the 6 resistors, popping them in where they're supposed to be. Maybe use a Sharpie to make sure they're going in the right place. And solder them down and then cut those legs off. Lovely, yeah, doing all that, looking great. Maybe use an iPhone to find out what color codes they are and all that jazz. Then I've got, you know, these ones. These actual capacitors are optional because they're power filters. They stop, like, all the buzzes annoying other modules. But you don't need them there. This one you do, it's a polar one, so check the polarity of that electrolytic capacitor. And then you pop some more capacitors in. There's a shot of the upside down bit. And now it's time to put the components onto the back of the valve socket. Oh, this is very quick moving. And there's a couple of capacitors. There's a resistor on the jack socket. And now we're making the ground wire. It can just be bare wire, and that's connecting all the grounds together. And now we're gonna start soldering all of those colored wires. I think they're matching the same as the actual schematic. Oh, I forgot that bit. Mounting it actually onto the panel. I'm using a hexagonal standoff. There's a link on the website to one. And then you get the wires, and you all get all the color codes. They can all be the same color, but for this is just so it looks a little clearer to you, so it looks the same as the actual picture on the website. Oh, there we go, we're going and soldering to all of where it's supposed to be. Please don't judge me on my soldering skills, it's all self-taught and I don't profess to be very good at soldering. And then you get a cable tied to keep it all neat, but make sure that it all works before, because you don't want to have to cut that cable tie because you've made one silly mistake. It's fine, people make mistakes, I make a lot of them. And this is my chosen power option. It's one of those. There is a link on my website for that.
And then, yeah, look at that, it's done. You know, it's a bit quick moving, but I didn't want to bore the socks off you. And yeah, look at that. The only thing that is left is, oh, the finale. Putting on the 12AX7, also known as the ECC83. Push it in there, make sure you get the pins in the right place. It's pretty hard to do wrong, but you know, there's probably somebody that's gonna do it wrong. And then you admire your workmanship before you put it in and realize it just doesn't work. But you know, with a couple of tweaks, you'll notice you've done one silly mistake and suddenly boom, it'll work and it'll be the best thing you've ever done. Well, maybe. I mean, I'm sure you've done better, but this was the best thing I've ever done, I promise.
There we go. It was as easy as that. I also put this one together. This is basically just two of them, one going into the other and then going into the amplification circuit. I'm going to plug them up and see what they sound like. So this is it on bypass. And let's turn it on. So I'm gonna put the volume on max. Oh, crazy. Of them. As you can tell, it doesn't sound like any old distortion. It sounds like a proper muffled up, weird, crazy thing. You can actually feedback these on themselves and they can sort of become an oscillator. Let me show you. So now instead of a signal going through, I've put the output and input into a multiple, so they're both connected together and then connected to another multiple, the output audio. And now when I turn it up, it sort of acts like an oscillator. So I hope the Valvecaster's little brother, the safety valve, was of interest to some of you and you might go and try it. I'm trying to do more projects like this and the keyboard sequencer in the future, and I would have never in a million years made it as proper as I have done if it wasn't for the supporters on Patreon, because I'm making it for them. So if you want to hear more about upcoming plans for these how-tos, please go and check the Patreon, because with more support, the projects get bigger and crazier. And yeah, don't forget to subscribe. I've been Look Mum No Computer. Bye!